We're good. Yeah.
What's up, everybody? Hello, and happy welcome to Friday night. My name is Billy Floyd. That is
Commodore.
That's right, baby. We're the Kitchen Killaz from Orlando, Florida, coming to you live from Coco. We are here in her brand new kitchen.
Girl
Laura Edinger made it happen. She has an absolutely amazing house, a beautiful place surrounded by incredible people. We have an excellent menu for you tonight. We have a brand new original song to share with you guys as well, and I hope that you're having a really good evening. I hope you guys had a really great week. My man Clayton, good to see
tonight.
You. Jen Holland, all the way from Pennsylvania. Good. I was like, what? Tara Dunn, good to see you. I hope Dennis is, you know, taking care of you. I saw the knee thing,
There's
man.
Dennis.
Let me
What's
give me
up?
A hug. Give me a knee hug. There we go. You're good.
What's up, Mad Scientist?
So thank you guys for joining
Can't
us tonight.
To
I know Debbie.
Good.
Hello.
Hi, Mom.
The Mamador. What's up, dog? Good to see you, man.
Mom.
Thank you guys for joining us tonight, and we most certainly appreciate it. A huge shout out to Shelly Wheeler for kicking butt and taking names on this beautiful, beautiful sign. Just to let you guys know, Facebook broadcasts everything in reverse, which is why this looks backwards to us, but to you, it looks so, so sweet. We have some really amazing people in the house hanging with Web Show. Great, great to see you guys. Lynn Floyd, good to see you. We have the illustrious and the magnanimous Jim Dunn here as well. I don't know how he got away from the anklet on his ankle that keeps the police chasing him. There's a little human right down here. Hold on, there he goes. Hi. But we're looking forward to a really great night, and thank you guys for joining us. Most certainly, the likes, the shares, the notifications make it happen, and I hope you are having a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Friday, and thank you for joining us once again. I want to say we have probably broken 70 kitchens in the state of Florida. We have played with Lauren before. We were in her dad's kitchen last time, I think, which was super cool, and what a beautiful kitchen.
Yep.
She made beef Wellington, and tonight she has an incredible
menu.
I saw an edible arrangement over there. What's up, edibles.com? Not that kind of edible. Calm down. It's not after 9:30. Family show. Chill out, everybody. Take it easy.
I saw a couple eyebrows raised in the audience.
What? Kyle Deuce, good to see you guys, and thank you for joining us tonight. We're going to kick it off, baby. We started off with an original, and if you guys have any questions or requests, let us know. If we know, if we'll play it. If we don't, we will direct you to an iTunes download link for $1.29. You can purchase your very own copy. It sounds just like the real thing. It's crazy. So thanks. I appreciate it. Allison, great to see you. Sarah, great to see you. Good to see you guys. It's wonderful, wonderful. It's like a family reunion every Friday.
Every Friday. So good to see you guys.
That's right. I see Kyle Deuce from Happy Hour with Johnny and Deuce. It's good to see you. This is called The Jilted Lover.
Freedom breaks down everything about me. Skipping steps to save me. Keeping fire from ice. And frozen is my will and power to be free. Despite the world around me, I'm broken by design. And I believe that I will stand alone. And I will bear my soul and bones to lay to rest the hatred in your heart. And let me see the love will find a way to send all my pain away. The sheltered shadow dreams that you lost along your I'll stand alone. I'll stand alone. And I'll stand alone. Ignoring your belief in a system built with paper beams supporting dreams of a vision that you'll never have to see. But I will find my way despite the time it takes. The world is built in 7 days, and in 7 days I'll break. So please believe the love will find a way to send all my pain away, to shelter shattered dreams that you lost along your way. And I'll stand alone, bare feet burning on that stone, by singing with my soul. I'll stand alone. And I will bear my soul in hopes you've laid to rest the hatred in your heart. And let me see, the love will find a way to send all my pain away to shelter shattered dreams that you lost along your way. And I'll stand alone, the deep end on that stone, by singing with my soul. My words will reach the clouds as angels sing out loud. And I'll stand alone, the deep end on that stone, by singing with my soul. My words will reach the clouds as angels sing out loud. Angels sing out loud. I'll stand, angels sing out loud. And I'll stand alone.
That.
I feel like I had to bow three times because there's people from here.
No, that was awesome, man. This is really cool.
Over to there.
It's getting hot in here, and I like it. Oh. So I hope you guys are having a good night. We got Brown from Hearts Helping Others hanging out. Good to see you. My man Josh Bauer is in the house tonight, incredibly dressed, looking amazing, smelling amazing. He's got brand new glasses and a new Tom and Dan hat, and we love him. And from what I understand, he just won a bet with Bunny this morning. He gets a back rub and waffles tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. He didn't even know that, but congratulations, sir.
Yay.
You are welcome. You're a deserving husband and a giving lover, from what Bunny tells me. So thank you guys for joining us tonight. We are super, super excited to be here. Lord Edinger has successfully purchased and manifested amazingness inside this house, and we are in a brand new and beautiful, beautiful kitchen. So thank you guys for joining us tonight. Elizabeth Ann, great to see you. Kevin B. Blood, my main man from Maine. Good to see you, my dude. Yeah.
By the way.
Oh yeah, my main man from Maine, man. That's right, Jen Holland. It's good to see you guys.
Our kitchen's so small, and we're like, yeah, we do small kitchens.
We play
but
small
somebody
kitchens.
Comes with a big kitchen, we're like, whoa.
I just feel like getting my skates on.
I want to stretch.
It's so big. It's awesome. So thank you guys for spending some time with us, man. This next one we did not write. However, my girl Sandy loves it, and I am so happy that she is here tonight. She is from Bavard Film and Talent. She makes it all happen, baby. She's an incredibly wonderful, creative person that just loves to spread that positivity all over the place, just like it making it rain positivity, baby. That's how it happens. So that last one was called The Jilted Lover. That is a KitchenKillaz original. We do have a bunch of more songs for you guys tonight, and we have a brand new original that we are going to be playing for you, which I'm super, super excited about. We've been working on that one for a while. The Great Comer came up with an awesome lick. All I did was put some vocals to it and made it happen. This next one is called Problem Girl by Rob Thomas. Hope you guys like it.
Don't let them get where they're going to. You know they're only what they think of you. Heard of this emotional trickery? You felt like you were learning the ropes, but where you're going now, you don't know. When the kids on the street say, "What's your problem, girl?" and the weight of that smile gets too much for you to bear. When they all make you feel like you're a problem, girl, you're no problem at all. You're no problem at all. Pride like promises will get you down. Thought that you'd be feeling better by now, and you worry all the things they could do to you, and you worry about the things they could say. Maybe you're seeing things the wrong way. When the kids on the street say, "What's your problem, girl?" that a smile gets too much for you to bear. When they all make you feel like you're a problem, girl, you're no problem at all. You're no problem at all. kids on the street say, what's your problem, girl? And the weight of the smile gets too much for you to bear. When they all make you feel that your problem, girl, try. If you stand or you fold, try. You're no problem at all. You're no problem at all. Don't let them get where they're going. Don't let them get where they're going to. You're no problem at all.
Yeah, baby. What's up, everybody? Good to see you tonight, and thank you for spending some time with us. My name is Billy Floyd, and that is... Yeah, baby. My man Matthew said he loves it. He's going to buy all our merch. So just to let you guys know, we play Friday nights for free. We lean on you guys. We lean on your donations. And we have merch sales at this beautiful merch table right behind you. So if you want to keep the Kitchen Killaz killing, baby, by all means, pull out some pocket lint and donate that in your laundry change. We know you got a couple dimes, quarters, nickels sitting in the cup holder of your car, in the couch cushions of your couch, or your couch cushions in your dryer. Who knows? Josh Bauer puts couch cushions in his dryer.
In
maniac.
You don't need them. Spend them on something that... needs them.
That's true, that's true. Like paper cups for mouthwash, which I found in Chick-fil-A yesterday. I was in Chick-fil-A. I gotta share this with you.
10 seconds.
I went into the bathroom yesterday, washed my hands, Chick-fil-A, and they had a mouthwash station that said, for your luxury. And I was like, what? That's crazy. I took a picture.
Like freshening our breath.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Hand sanitizer, soap, and mouthwash. Chick-fil-A, you are changing the game one day at a time. And I love it. Mike Shaw, great to see you.
It's my pleasure.
That is very true. Oh, nice. It's great to see you guys, and thank you for joining us. Everybody that is hanging out in Jen Holland's Watch Party, Flower Power's Watch Party, or Autumn Rain's Watch Party, thank you guys very much for hanging out. Thank you for the likes, the notifications, and by all means, if you make it to the main feed, let us know. And anybody that comes from a watch party to the main feed, reach out, send us your name, and Lauren Edinger will come to your house and make you beef Wellington whenever you want. It's absolutely incredible. She's a fantastic chef. It's her favorite thing to make, and she travels all over the world, and she'll do it for free. So, Colin Nunez, you're in Trinidad. Lauren wants to go to Trinidad. No big deal. You want beef Wellington in your mouth? Lauren will make it happen. It's just the way that it works, baby. She's a giver. She's a very lovely person. It's true. It ain't a lie, baby. That last one was called Problem Girl. That was a Rob Thomas show. Right after this song, we're going to introduce you to our hostess with the mostest. She's going to come up here, hopefully, and we're going to give away some more of her furniture that she doesn't need anymore. I mean, I'm just saying, like
she's
I said,
she
cares. She can't run. We're portable. Yeah.
I mean, she knows, she knows we're going to do it, so she just doesn't want to
hear. We will chase you down. So thank you guys very much, man. We hope you're enjoying yourselves. And by all means, check out our YouTube channel.com/KitchenKillaz, Instagram, Twitter, all the Kitchen Killaz stuff. Just Google it, baby, and make it happen. And I would love to see some new likes and some notifications. And we only have 3 dates left in the year of 2019 before we're booked solid. That was our goal, was to be booked 6 months in advance. We're 3 dates away. So if you have a kitchen like to be crashed, help us achieve our dreams. We do it for free, baby. My man Matthew gives great foot rubs as well. He's right there, and he knows it. You can go to MatthewGivesTheBestFootRubs.com and sign up for your monthly newsletter.
I want a foot rub by Matthew. Woo!
That's right, baby. Make it happen. We give away a lot of stuff, Matthew. I hope that's okay. He's laughing. He can't say no, so that means yes. This one's called Be My Queen. I hope you guys enjoy it.
With me hand in hand through all the pain, and when you held me tight and I screamed within my dream, and how you followed me through the darkness and the rain. And won't you hold me tight and never let me go? And won't you follow me, and I would follow you, and we could face that day. We'll never be alone, and you can be my queen as you sit upon this throne. Thank you.
Now and then when I'm thinking about those days when we would laugh out loud over candlelight and rain, and we would cuddle close, I'd protect your soul from flaming. You would comfort me through the night and day by day, and won't you hold me tight and never let me go, and won't you follow me, and I would follow you, and we could face that day, we'll never be alone, and you could be my queen as you sit upon this throne. Move a few steps closer to me, baby, if only for the night, then won't you take my hands and yours, and please trust me as we then kiss goodbye. For in my dreams I'll always have you right here with me, but when I wake at night and reach into the darkness, I remember those times we say this love's for life, when I would hold you tight and never let you go, and I would watch you fly and you would watch me flow, and we could face that day, we'll never be alone, and I could be your king as I sat upon this throne, when you would hold me tight and never let me go, and I would watch you fly and you would watch me flow, and we could face that day, we'll never be alone, and I would be your king as you sat upon this throne. I see that clap over there, Sandy. Love you. So what's up, everybody? And ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our hostess with the mostess, Laura Edinger, if you want to join us on camera, baby. Laura,
she's right there.
Hi,
everybody.
Lauren, thank you so much for having us. This is a beautiful kitchen. Now, not only did we crash your dad's kitchen when you were there, but we were also at Dragon Con together last year. And I think you were cosplaying Belle that night.
Yep.
And the food you made was in
Boudoir Belle.
Boudoir Belle. I stand corrected.
Big difference.
Oh, it was a big difference. Well, that sounded dirty. I didn't mean it for it to sound like that. But thank you so much for having us. This is awesome. So this is like a combination housewarming party and a KitchenKillaz party, and you have a ton of food. This is awesome. What have you created tonight? And we have some growlers, from what I understand.
Yes.
Oh,
I made
I've been growling since
chili.
I got here.
He's been drinking.
That's what that means.
Growling, drinking.
I made just chili, three bean chili. And
just chili.
Yep.
And Lauren Edinger doesn't just make anything.
Yeah. Cornbread and a jalapeno cornbread.
Ooh, jalapeno.
Yeah, so you probably just dumped three cans that you got at Publix into a big pot and cooked it for
no
8
love,
hours, right?
Which is not
yeah,
right.
No, didn't
lots
think
of passion,
so.
Lots of love.
Not even close.
Yeah, I think
excellent cook.
I think
she's
we were talking around 2 o'clock
like
today, and
nothing.
She was like, "I'm the kitchen is crazy. I'm cooking tons of food," and it was 2 o'clock. It was 7 hours ago.
Knew it.
So she's most certainly been working really hard, and she started last night. Exactly.
With the Jell-O.
Don't talk down your chili. Oh, you started with the Jell-O last night.
Yeah.
That sounds fun.
Jell-O. I'm sorry. What?
The Jell-O.
Jell-O. What's in the Jell-O? Oh, liquor.
Rum.
There's
rum.
Is that what the
and
R
vodka.
Is for? Or is it red?
There's a V for vodka.
Oh, there's R for rum and V. Oh, I love that. That's
I think
really
I should.
You don't want to mix them up.
I should try a rum and a vodka and see which one I like better.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. I think it's a good. While
there's
you think
flavors.
I think so.
Oh, yeah. No, everybody's watching the show. They just voted again at the same time, especially Brian Gaylord. Brian Gaylord put both hands
I'm
up.
I'm going to try both
Do
of
you
them.
Want to try the rum first or the but vodka first?
Well, I know what vodka tastes like.
You know what rum
in
tastes
a,
like.
In a Jell-O shot. I've never had rum in a Jell-O
well,
shot.
Well, guess
though.
What, buddy? First time for everything. I'm going to let you do that. I'm going to snag one of these growlers that we're going to talk about. Ooh, which
I don't know
one
if you guys
do?
Are familiar with
do
this.
Do it, do it. Give it the pinky. Wow. Ooh, I'm not even familiar with that. Oh, wow.
We got 5 more minutes.
Woo. It didn't work. Okay, I got it now. I got it. We're good.
Dude, look at the texture of the Jell-O. It's perfect. That's almost a perfectly clean one right there. That means she made the Jell-O with love as well. I mean, I'm excited. That's
awesome.
I mean, there's
awesome. A lot of alcohol in it.
Is a good amount of alcohol in it or not enough alcohol in it? Which one was that? Good? Perfect?
It tastes phenomenal.
All right, that's what I'm talking about, baby. Well, it's rum! What up, Jim Callaher? Great, great, great to see you, my man. That's three greats. You get three because you're just such a good guy. That's. Well, I'm excited for the
He's worthy
one.
Of three. I've been
Let's
his
start
house.
With
we need
that was a lot of fun.
Let's start with the smoochie.
That's my jam.
The
right
smoochie
there.
Moochie. Dude, where are these from? These are from the Dirty Oar. Dude, they even have their own personalized growlers?
Yeah.
That is awesome. Wow, 64 fluid ounces of growler deliciousness. Smoochie moochie, all up in your gullet, baby.
Smoochie hoochie. It's really good.
Oh, that's
and
an
sexy
H?
Beach.
That looks like an M.
Yeah, yeah, it's not.
Maybe she opened it up before she started writing words.
I didn't like that.
No, we have a couple tonight.
And sexy beach.
Sexy beach.
I think that's
that.
That's the one that I wanted.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is this the one
I don't
you
remember.
I think I ordered
Lauren is such
sexy
a great
beach.
Hostess. She reached out before we even came here and she was like, everybody gets to choose their own growler. You let us know what you want. And the one I picked, she was like, that's what I always get. I'm like, that's dangerous.
Well, it's funny because I picked a sexy beach and when I got here, she's like, you picked this one. I'm like, okay, I'll have a glass. And I had a glass and it was delicious.
And another glass.
And she's like, hey, do you want to try a different one? I was like, no.
I'm good. Good.
And normally I like a little variety. I'll try everything. You know, let's see what we got. But no, I'm good.
So what is the smoochie hoochie? What is what flavors pop first? What are the most proliferant, profound ones that
you... I
want
to say like a floral / fruit taste.
Nice.
It's not
goes
sweet
down easy,
enough.
Baby.
It's not sweet enough to be a fruit
like
flavor.
I gotcha.
But the floral is like it's. I don't want to say effervescence because that's not right.
Effervescence is almost, a fun word though. You know you want to say it. Say it. Effervescence.
It's hard to say when you're,
you know you've
had a couple girls.
Oh no, it is.
So I steer away from an order.
It's a sparkling ale.
Word.
Yeah.
Well, so you know it is.
Yeah, effervescence. Yeah, it works. It's a sparkling ale. It's got the bubbles, bro.
Yeah.
Yep.
I love it.
Effervescent. We're going to put that in the description. It's effervescent.
That's awesome.
And floral.
Smoochie, hoochie.
And fruity.
But you haven't had sexy beach yet.
No.
And this is the one you actually ordered.
That
no.
One
but you
is
haven't
like
had
it.
You remember the
coconut and
strawberry?
Ooh, can really we try
good.
That?
Yeah. Coconut and
you know what
strawberry
we should do?
Is it good?
Is there anybody out there that would like a sample of the sexy beach?
They would
look
like
how fast those hands up, man. Those hands went up fast. Is there anybody out there would like, yes?
I don't care, my glass is
man, this is awesome. So this is what we're going to do. We already had the great Commodore sample the smoochie hoochie and talk about that one. We're going to have somebody sample the sexy beach and pop on the camera next, and we're going to talk about it a little bit.
That's what Shelly
Shelly's on the camera all the time. We'll get her up next. After she has a couple more, then we'll get her on the camera. That's when it gets really fun. Yeah, baby, that is awesome. So thank you guys for joining us tonight. And these are all provided by the Dirty Oar. That's right, man. Absolutely incredible. They have these awesome 64-ounce growlers, which I think
this
is a great reason to move locally. That's it, man. This is super, super cool. Dirty Oar Beer Company, founded in 2017. Not bad. Only 2 years, and you're creating this. You're changing the game, baby, and I love it. Sweet. I'm going to give this back to the Commodore real fast before I lose stuff. There we go. We're safe. Everything is okay. So thank you for joining us tonight. We most certainly appreciate it. My name is Billy Floyd, and that is...
on the Commodore.
That's right, baby. We're the Kitchen Killaz from Orlando, Florida, coming to you live from Cocoa. We are here at Lauren Edinger's house, cosplayer, photographer, and a phenomenal mom. I didn't know how to order those today because I would say mom would go first and then the other two would trail. And Evie's running around here eating ketchup-covered corn, which I thought was
God,
a great idea.
Why is she doing that?
What a great
because
idea.
Really.
I don't know. I forgot how impressionable young children are. I just thought it was a good idea. Oh, are you ready for this one next? This will be next. This is the vodka one.
Are we doing?
Do you want to do both of those? It's up to
like,
you,
I'm
man.
Wasted,
oh, we're not knocking it out. This is vodka, and I want to say this is lime jello.
It's green.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Unless they dyed it green to just trick us.
It's not really lime. We're watching you, JELLO. I see what's going on over there. So thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for the likes and the shares. Thank you for the notifications. We most certainly appreciate it. Again, we have 3 dates left. Again?
It's
again?
Like, I got it. It's not like,
dude, just pull, look how perfect that. Well, it was perfect. Now it's gone. That's how you know it's good. Wow. That was awesome, man. So is it truly lime or were they lying? Oh, yeah. Double thumbs up from the Commodore. That's what I'm talking about. You can go to commodore.bombacore.com and you can sign up for his Jello newsletter. It's pretty crazy. Every month he sends out a brand new Jello shot recipe for you to make, baby, and put directly in your mouth and then tell us all about it. Mm-hmm. This next one we didn't write, however, I hope you guys appreciate it. This is from the late and amazing Dolores from the Cranberries. Ladies and gentlemen, this is called Linger. The Commodore makes it sound so pretty. So sexy, yeah. It's true. Matthew knows.
Here we go.
Found it.
We're good.
And if you could return.
Don't let it burn, don't let it fade. I'm sure I'm not being rude, just your attitude. It's tearing me apart, it's ruining everything. For me, I swore I would be true, fellow, so did you. So why were you holding a hand? Is that the way we stand? Were you lying all the time? Was it just a game to you? But I'm in too deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? Oh, I thought the world of you, and I thought nothing could go wrong. But I was wrong, I was wrong. And if you could get by trying not to lie, things wouldn't be so confused, wouldn't feel so used. But you always really knew I just wanna be with you, and I'm in so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? Such a fool for you. You've got me wrapped around your finger. Ooh. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? And I'm in so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You've got me wrapped around your finger. To let it linger. What's up, everybody? Thank you guys for joining us tonight. My name is Billy Floyd, and that is
Commodore.
That's right, and we just had a couple people try this excellent, excellent drink, and I want to see if any of them, I know we had three, we had Sandy, we had Bunny, and we
had
Vic, who looks like she's still enjoying it. And it's called, what is it, Sexy Beach?
Sexy Beach.
That's right. Bunny, you want to chat about it? Sandy, would you like to talk about it? Sandy said, give me three more, and then she'll talk about it, and I like that. That is awesome. Vic, you want to pop up and chat about it real quick? Yes, she does. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause, the one, the only. It's good to see you. I think the last time you were here, you were Wonder Woman.
I was.
I love that. We got so many views on that, and I was just like, wow. Like, that was so awesome.
It you
was
just
like,
get playing me today.
Oh, playing? Get out of here. What are you talking about, dude? Thank you so much for coming. Now, you and Lauren have worked together several different times. You and Pepe and Lauren have done several different photo shoots.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
That is so cool, man. How long have you guys known each other?
I think we're going over a year and a half now that
nice.
We've known each other.
What
yep.
a cool community.
Oh,
I will say, like, the whole community here is just so awesome. It's so fun. There's so many accepting people that just want to see everybody succeed and thrive and try new things. And it's really great to see everybody work together. I didn't know you guys were coming tonight. And when I saw Pepe's hair first, I'm not going to lie.
I know it's better than mine.
Stunning locks. I'm just saying, he walked in. I was like, I already knew it was going to be a good night, but it warmed my heart to see you guys. It's so good to see you guys. So we just tried Sexy Beach from the Dirty Oar.
Yes.
And what did you think? Are you a Sexy Beach fan?
So I am. I normally don't drink like lighter beers or anything like that. I like my dark stouts and stuff, but that was really good.
Yeah?
It had little notes of everything.
She said notes. She knows what she's talking about.
She's using important words. I love it. That is awesome. So what beer do you normally go to, or ale or IPA, or what do you kind of lean on?
Typically like Guinness. Like, okay. I like dark coffee stouts.
Real dark.
Yes.
Well, that's awesome, man. That's what I'm talking about. So to have something like this, even though it's on the completely opposite end of the spectrum, we really enjoyed it.
I did. I drank half of my cups before you finished singing.
So it goes pretty quick.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, it goes pretty quick. That's so a scale of 1 to 10. Would you get it again?
Absolutely.
Nice. And yes. And for those out there to recommend it, what would you say? A scale of 1 to 10. Where's like 1, don't get it, 10, buy it only, or
8.5.
That's
I'm
awesome.
Right up there. So,
yeah,
yes.
Babe, that's what I'm talking about. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause. That's right, baby. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. We most certainly appreciate it.
Yeah, baby.
Oh, that's right.
Beer.
I'll be right back.
Welcome to Friday night, everybody. Every Friday night at 9:05, you can catch us doing the same exact similar thing on a Friday night. Similar style room, kitchen, with similar, same guitars. Same people, same guitars. Kind of different scenario. You know what I mean. Every Friday night at 9:05, you can find us on Facebook Live.
I love this thing. This is such a cool thing. Like,
hey, Lauren's dad is part owner of this brewery.
What? Where's Lauren's dad? Is Lauren's dad here? There he is. I see him. Congratulations,
like, yeah,
sir.
It's me.
An entrepreneur through and through, baby. That's what I'm talking about. That is awesome. Dude, that's a wise decision, sir. Why? He's like, yeah, I know. That's the only kind I make.
It's true. He's a pretty smart guy. So in addition to Friday nights at 9:05, you can also find us in the same very location on Monday nights and Wednesday nights at 7:05. We do live videos all the time.
That's true. All the time.
You just got to push the button and be like, oh, there's Billy and the Commodore.
What's up?
Let's hang out and listen to some music.
Talking about food, talking about drinks, playing some music, having a good time. And by all means, don't forget.
Where music
Matthew gives the best foot massages.com. I'm serious. Whoa. You can go there right now and sign up for his monthly newsletter. How do you think he got such a lovely lady? Foot
he's
massages,
actually telling everyone, like, I'm ready to give a foot massage. Is no one ready for me to give them a foot massage? Like,
I think after a couple of those growlers are empty, they're going to jump on it.
Yeah, those growlers are empty.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for spending some time with us. This next one is a Kitchen Killaz original. I hope you guys enjoy this, man. This is off the Arsonist album, and it will also be on our upcoming album featuring the Kitchen Killaz as a duet. Amazing. Some acoustics in your face. We're recording with my man Clayton Duran, who's in here right now. We are just about a week away from that, which we're super excited about. A man walks alone down a dusty road. Half in the shadow of sunlight, half in the glow. The stone cloud raves and preaches, says I can do the most to make that walking man take off his walking coat. So boom braves that storm. Blowing ripples across the pond, blowing leaves attached from bed trees, turning cypress to its knees. In the end, my friend, begin again. A man walks alone down a dusty road. Half in the shadow of sunlight, half in the down that sun, coming the balls and the pond, growing leaves attached from their trees, turning to rest to its knees. In the end, my friend, begin again. In the end, my friend, begin again. Oh no, so shines down that sun, coming the balls and the pond, growing leaves attached from their trees, turning to rest to its knees. In the end, my friend, begin again. A man walks alone. The sun, he sets that storm down. Says, listen here, my friend, to get that walking coat off, off of that walking man. You take a pinch of sunlight and you hold it in your hand, and you take a dash of true love, toss it in the sand. Now close your eyes and make a wish, blowing from your hand. This brand new kitchen. She has created some amazing food. She's packed it with amazing people.
Amazing!
All the amazingness, baby. The very first time we actually crashed her dad's kitchen, which was awesome. An incredible kitchen, beautiful, and she made beef Wellington. And again, if you guys remember our competition, she will fly anywhere in the world and make you beef Wellington for free.
Even Trinidad.
How? Even Trinidad, Kyle Nunez. I'm looking at you, sir. That's right. Terry, he's in here from Ireland. I don't know when the last time she was in Ireland, but she had a wonderful time and she would love to go back. Who doesn't want beef Wellington homemade in Ireland? That's right, everybody does. That's right, man. I hope you guys are having a really good night, and thank you for joining us. We most certainly appreciate it. The likes, the shares, the notifications. It's what keeps the whole thing going, man. We have 3 dates open, and we have 1 in November, and we have 2 in December to crash kitchens on Friday nights. We do it for free. We lean on your support for donations and merch sales, but that's what we do, baby. You bring the people, you prepare the food, or we can have the mad scientist come.
What?
That's right. If you don't want to cook, it's no big deal. We have the mad scientist, and he is a hot commodity, baby. He's not always available, but if he is, he creates appetizers, entrees, desserts, incredible cocktails so you can entertain, you can take it easy, you can enjoy yourself, and we can make it happen while you just enjoy your Friday night. That's how we do it, baby. And if you want to, I know this is taking it way out on the ledge because he doesn't know I'm about to do this. Bless you. My man Josh Bauer loves to live paint. He'll do it on camera so we can all join you in your kitchen. Some amazing painting, some delicious food, some incredible music. Hopefully, I guess I talk myself up a little better, and the Commodore is way better than I am. Plus, look at that mohawk.
Get out of here.
That's right. Distraction. Bam. That's right,
here.
Man. We the full Monty. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. That was all. So thank you guys for joining us. Most certainly, Kyle Nunez said beef Wellington on the beach in Trinidad sounds great. You got it, sir. Pick a date, and Lord Edinger will head that way.
No idea what you just signed up for, man.
We are really excited.
It's on fire.
Oh, yeah, man. It's amazing. It's amazing. Hello, Evie. How are you? She loves us. And now she likes corn with ketchup on it. You're welcome. I'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen. Here's the Commodore. I'm going to change a flat tire.
Well, he's changing a flat growler. Yeah, that's where that came from. Well, he's changing a flat tire on an imaginary car. Actually, imaginary tire. I'm going to talk about what we have going on this weekend. Absolutely nothing. We're going to be relaxing this weekend. After tonight, we're going to take it easy for like a day. And then on Monday, we'll wrap it up again. So on Monday at 7:05, you can join us on Facebook Live. And we're going to talk about everything that happened this past week, which is like 78 things. So it could be like a 7-minute video, maybe more. But we're going to talk about all that. Fast forward to the next day, Tuesday at noon, we're going to put up a poll of 2 of our originals, 3 of our cover, 3 of our covers. I say our covers like they're ours. They're not ours.
But we play them.
Covers that we borrow for a short time just so we can play them and you can enjoy them.
We paid for them.
So, long story short, 2 originals, 3 covers.
No, we didn't.
We're going to let you vote. You can pick as many as you want.
Also
we encourage you to pick 2. Not just 1, but 2. If you want to pick all 5 because you like all 5.
You can pick all 5.
That's an option.
Hit all the buttons.
Kyle Nunez.
All the boop boops, baby. Make
it
happen.
He does it
happen.
Every time. Is it Kyle or Terry that does it every time? I think it's Kyle.
I think both of them.
I think they both do it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No,
and then they comment and be like, I just picked all 5.
Yeah, I think both of them. And
I think
that's totally cool. Click all 5. We love it when you click our buttons, Terry. Yeah, baby.
So much fun.
We didn't write this one, however, I hope you guys appreciate it, man, because it's super groovy. Thank you.
storm takes me away from the norm. I've got to tell you something. This phenomenon, and I put it in a song, and it goes like, whoa. Amber is the color of your energy. Whoa. Brings talk coming to naturally. You wanna know what brings me here? Straight through your brain, blind to fear. And you know that, whoa. Amber is the color of your energy. Whoa.
From way back there than you do normally he does pick to the camera really close, he lets it go, but this one he let it way back here, bro. That was crazy. That was awesome.
You man, can't do it like
nah,
that.
No, you got those heavy picks, bro. They cut through the air, they slice air.
Well, yours are kind of curved.
That's true, they are. Whoop. That's okay, you can have a curved one, it's fine.
I actually prefer mine actually was in the car and it got super hot and it curved like this. And it's actually much easier to grip. So
when you get your
out.
Fender picks, put them in your car in the Florida sun for a while, and then they're amazing.
And they'll form like that. I don't know. I haven't quite figured all of it out.
That's okay. We'll figure it out. We just go as we go, man. We don't even know. Matthew DeFore, great to see you. Kitchen Killer Critic in the house, baby. Kyle Deuce, good to see you. And thank you for spending some time with us tonight. Jen Holland, great to see you. Mia Dawn Blood, all the way from Maine. So good to see so many familiar faces. Thank you guys very, very much. I see some brand new names as well. So thank you guys for joining the feed. Please let us know how you found out about the show and let us know if you've got a kitchen you would like us to get all up in. That's fine. That sounded weird, but it's okay because it's love, you know. It's the best kind of love, free love. That's right, because we do it for free. Every Friday night, we travel all over the country, hopefully one day, and one day all over the world. And we crash kitchens every Friday night for free, baby, so let us know. We'll most certainly make it happen, man. Josh Bauer, great to see you. Found out about you guys from a homeless guy. No big deal, that's fine. If you found out about us from a homeless guy, I'm totally down for that. So just to let you guys know, this is a brand new Kitchen Killaz original. We are debuting it right here in Lauren Edinger's house because she's so awesome. And because she has offered to fly all over the world and make beef Wellington for anybody for free.
Yes, yes. Even to Trinidad.
Even at Trinidad, Kyle Nunez. Beef Wellington on the beach in Trinidad. What? I think she already went to Expedia.com to see if she can book her flight and her ride at the same time.
She already booked it, she told me.
It's already done?
It's already done. I hope you...
Hope you have a good time. Lauren, have you already left? She's probably left already. Probably already gone. No, no, she's there. Her flight leaves tonight at 11:30. This is called Elevate.
My denominator, elevated thoughts surrounding you. As parallels don't drift or settle, mind me as I kind of fall for you. With these bending lines and diamond bites reflecting bright white light right back through you. Within the lips so first in prep, why don't you pull the kiss from me too? I won't interject, but I digress as that lip dress falls fast from nose to. Fit to wood, there goes your good right out that door with what could, should, and might. In this moment, let's jump on it, fingertips to hips as lips turn light tonight. As candles turn and moments burn, this hesitation in my soul for you. This wall crashes down here where this crown and drown that frown way down from true to true. With tender lips so first in prep, why don't you pull that kiss from me too? I won't interject, but I digress as that red dress falls fast from nose to. In that afterglow, we'll fall in close some way, let the dogs crawl straight down to. All these fears that pin us to these stars and tears. With candle lips so first in prep, why don't you pull that kiss from me too? I won't interject, but I digress as that red dress falls fast from nose to. In that afterglow, we'll fall in close, let's let the deep dark start straight down to. Oh, don't tell a soul, the less they know, the better it will be from me too.
Awesome. That was cool, man.
That was fun.
You got it, baby. I hope you guys enjoyed that, and thank you for spending some time with us tonight. We got a couple songs left for you, and then we are going to get to a traditional cultural dance that Pepe has prepared for everybody here on Facebook, which I'm really excited about. I didn't even know that was happening, but Pepe messaged me earlier today. He's like, bro, I've been working really, really hard on the dance of my people, and I'm really excited to bring it onto the show. Now, I don't know if he's 100% prepared, but one day he said he's got to have a little bit of that sweet, sexy beach, and then he's gonna get up here and rock it out. I don't know if that's gonna happen, but we're hoping.
A sweet, sexy beach.
It is. I mean, he's got one sweet, sexy beach. But are you talking the drink? Oh, the drink.
I don't know what's going on anymore.
I don't even know what's happening right now.
That bitch's gonna dance. That's all I heard. That's all I heard.
Let's do Come Down. Can we do Come Down?
Okay. I like that song too. Be right back.
You look familiar. I think I've seen you on the internet.
No.
No, I have not seen you on the internet. I'm pretty sure.
Nobody's ever
been. No.
I don't do internet.
She does the internet. So thank you guys for Thank you guys for joining us tonight. We most certainly appreciate you hanging out with us. The likes and the shares. It's so good to see so many familiar names. Hanging with Web Show, always killing the baby. A huge shout out to all of our sponsors. Lakeland Barbecue, Bryland Imagery, Merchroom.com, Sarfa Brand out of California. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. We've also been working with Castle Door Studios out of Orlando. It is your one-stop shop, baby. They mix, they record, they do all the things. You can even ship them files from across the globe, and they will most certainly make that happen for you, baby. They will get you in touch with a phenomenal mastering artist to make sure that you sound crisp and clear and absolutely amazing. Hello, sir. How are you tonight? That's what. That's how you get little kids to run away. You just address them directly. And then they run. However, I gotta tell you, man, Evee introduced me to corn with ketchup tonight. What an amazing creation. I never had corn on the cob with ketchup. Evee was like, yo, Billy.
I don't think that's exactly how it happened.
No? No, it's not how it happened?
No. I think you just said some random shit, and she was like, yeah, I want to do that.
Does that sound like me?
Yes.
Anyone?
Wait a minute.
Anyone?
Whose side are you on? Damn. Well, thank you guys.
I'm just telling the truth over here. That's it.
And one of the most amazing sponsors that we've ever had, Josh Bauer. That's right, man. Jay Bauer R. You can find him on Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube every Thursday night at 7:30. He does a weekly and artist wrap-up where he gives you an idea of everything that he's done over the last 7 days and what he's got going on, baby. And he is booking like crazy. If you want him to book your live event, most certainly make it happen. He plays bat mitzvahs. He does parties. He does pool parties. He does shenanigans. Bat mitzvahs. He put up bat mitzvahs, and I just like saying that word.
I don't know how to get to them, but we're going to go.
We're going to make it happen, baby. That's right. If you have a restaurant you would like crush, we feature restaurants as well in your menu. We feature your chef. We'll have the mad scientist come if you want to and just kind of be there and give you his professional opinion, if you will.
He can be the tester.
I like
the
that.
Taster guy.
A good taste tester. A tester of taste.
Oh, yeah, baby. There's got to be a fancy name for that kind of person.
There must be. There must be. We'll think about it.
Maitre D is a fancy name for hostess.
And sommelier is a fancy name for some dude that knows a lot about wine.
Yeah, just drinks a lot.
Whatever you want. Oh, I mean, that may be it. That sounds like a fun job.
Is there a name for beer drinker?
Probably.
I drink a lot of beer.
An imbiber. Oh, yeah, baby. And then if you want, it's totally cool, man. We can feature Josh Bauer as well on any of the shows that you want him on. Just reach out and let us know. And if he's available, because he's a hot commodity, baby, we'll see if he can join us as well. This next one, he said, I'm always available for you, Bill. Wait a minute. This next one we did right. This is off the 16 Stone album. I know. From Bush.
I know.
Right back down the sides, sleep the days, let it fade. Who is there to take your place? No one knows, never will. Mostly me, mostly you. Do you say, do you do? When it all comes down, so I don't wanna come back down from this cloud. It's taking me all this time. Just complain. The more I come, the more I try. All police are paranoid. So am I. So is the future. So are you to be a creature. And do you say, and do you do? When it all comes down, why don't wanna come back down from this cloud? All this time. So I don't wanna come back down from this cloud. It's taking me all this time to find out what I mean, yeah. So I don't wanna come back down from this cloud. It's taking me all this time. Why don't wanna come back down from this cloud. It's taking me all this time to find out what I need. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I don't wanna come back down from this cloud. It's taking me all this time.
To the time of the evening where we lean on you to let us know what, oh, that was pretty good. You want to try it with one of these? I don't know. It's got a...
I gotta use the curve to my
advantage.
Yeah,
you gotta, I believe in you. I like
still
the weapons
saw
better.
It on the
yeah,
camera.
It kind of, it kind of swooped.
I just have a...
It swooped.
Like, the fender picks and I are one.
Like we, be one with the
we
fender
belong
pick.
Together.
We belong white together.
Fender picks, the white pearl.
Like peanut butter and jelly.
Pearl white fender
or
picks.
Or peanut butter and bananas. Yeah.
Hot peanut butter and jelly.
Or
toasted
grilled
peanut,
grilled
butter,
peanut
and
butter and jelly.
Careful,
what up? What up, Biggie Bencomo?
Super hot.
Oh, yeah.
When I
no,
was expecting
sure.
that.
No, no,
when
it's like lava
have
in your face.
Hot, a grilled
yeah,
peanut
a grilled
butter
peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Not toasted
I know
bread,
it sounds crazy, but
jelly,
try it.
But a grilled peanut butter
yeah.
and jelly. You
yeah.
take it off there and you gotta wait a second because the jelly is super hot. It's like
it's true.
Boiling and
it really
my
is.
Mouth,
it's crazy.
Yo.
And I want to say the way Biggie Bencomo did that one, especially with the grilled cheese, is I think he mixed butter and Duke's to crust the outside, Duke's
crazy
mayonnaise, to crust the outside of the bread. And then he had like 27 cheeses in the middle. Whack, whack, a doodle, baby. Nice, hot, iron skillet. Boom, boom. And don't, yeah, you gotta, don't walk away from it. I distracted
check
him.
Our,
he
our
almost
Monday
lit our kitchen
from,
on fire. It was crazy.
From,
he had to scrape it off with a knife, but he saved it. Totally
that.
Fine. But then he made grilled
Monday
peanut butter and jelly. I've never had
Monday
that before.
The 10th.
That was freaking, freaking
Monday
amazing.
You
didn't even know the peanut butter and the bread was good. The jelly almost melted my soul. It was crazy. It was extremely hot. So warning, hot, hot. This is the way it works, man.
It burnt my mouth.
I haven't been counting anything. I have no idea what's going on. I
oh,
see Tara Dunn pops in as
original.
Lynn Floyd popped in an original. Awesome. Thank you guys very much.
We didn't even start.
What did I do without you,
bunny?
We
didn't even start a vote thing. We're supposed to.
I mean, we did. No, we totally did.
Did we?
Yeah, we did. But then we started.
Attention.
I got distracted by the peanut butter and jelly sandwich song. Oh, song? What? Oh, that's a good idea. Thanks, guys. I appreciate that. That's what I'm talking about. A grilled peanut butter and jelly song? I would totally write one of those. Yeah, because I love
you know
it
what he's
going to
do tomorrow?
Much.
I was like, Jay, why don't you come up with a peanut
guess
butter and jelly
got.
Song? And we were like, all right. 5 minutes later, here you go.
Here you go. Peanut butter and jelly for your face. So this is going to do it for us, guys. Thank you guys for spending some time with us tonight, man. We most certainly appreciate it. Originally, he's definitely won, but I love the fact that you're still voting. That's right, man. Vote all you want, baby. Just keep it going. Kevin B. Blood, Elizabeth Ann, great to see you guys. And thank you for spending some time with us tonight. Lauren Edinger has been a phenomenal hostess. She has packed this place with absolutely amazing people, some awesome food, an edible arrangement over there, which just looks absolutely outstanding. Actually, I'm going to go get it. I'll be right back.
This is, you see how amazing this looks? It's missing things here, and here, and here. I ate most of these. These were grapes, and there was a cantaloupe piece on top of there. There's another grape. And this one's a,
in your face. Open your
this
mouth.
This one's an orange.
Eat it.
It won't come off.
Eat it.
There we go.
How freaking crazy is this? Edible arrangements. They arrange things, and then you eat them. It's such a genius idea. They got grapes, and cantaloupe, and honeydew, and pineapple, and strawberries. What? And oranges. Well, one less slice of orange. But that's okay. But yeah, man, that's what I'm talking about, Clayton. Look how freaking amazing that looks. This is the quality of people that Lauren Edinger hangs out with.
Yo, there's
the quality of people
here,
that bring
yo,
edible arrangement. Did you eat the kale? What? I don't know. I think that's decoration.
No, it's kale. It's got more nutrition.
Fruit in your face. Instead of fruit by the foot, fruit in your face. That's just the way that works, man. Sweet. I'm going to hit some buttons real quick. Here's the commentator. He's going to tell you what we got coming up this week, which I'm really excited about.
What do we have coming up this week? People ask me that all the time. When I get my phone out and I look at my calendar. I'm going to read them off a list of things that we're doing in the next day and a half. I'm not going to bore you with that. All you need to know is you can come to Facebook anytime and just check us out. We're probably either live or we posted a bunch of pictures or something like that about what we've been doing or what we're going to do. So you're always pretty much in the know. Unless you want to hear me talk about it, I'll just stand here and talk about it for a little bit. Or, oh, you know what? That's a great idea. Billy.
Thank you very much.
Idea.
It's the only kind I have.
Go to Instagram. If you don't have an Instagram account,
that's true.
That's all right.
That's okay. We love you anyway.
And check out our Instagram stories.
Stories.
There's a lot of behind the scenes stuff. There's
BTS. That's what the kids are calling it these days.
A lot of photos.
Very true.
If you will.
And Jen Holland just reminded us, Indie Scene Radio every Sunday at 12 p.m. My man Gerg coming up on his 6-year anniversary for Indie Scene Radio. Thank you so much, Gerg. Gerg has been supporting the Kitchen Kills for almost 2
years.
Exactly. That was almost a year ago. How crazy is that? Flying, baby, flying. I don't know who this J is you speak of, Kevin B. Blood. Who is this J? I don't know.
I would like to meet this guy.
I don't know who that means. He sounds like a pretty cool guy. I like that letter. It's a good letter. He's like super decisive, and then he decides to go the other way for a little bit. I love that.
Does he?
Yeah, that's what a J is. He's like, I'm going this way. Man, let me go this way. I'm going to stop and have a snack.
Yeah, he does a U-turn.
Yeah, probably like an
maybe
edible arrangement.
He just forgot.
Or a growler.
Or maybe he's on a road that is just stupid, and you have to make a U-turn to get where you're going.
Yeah, got to make a U-turn. Ha, it's crazy.
Where were we the other day, and I like drove around 3 different parking lots.
We couldn't
get
out.
To a road and just
everything was do not enter. We were trapped.
Like, where am I going? I want to get out of here.
That was crazy. That was the same Chick-fil-A parking lot that had the mouthwash.
I just thought of that. Yeah. It was a crazy night.
They were taking crazy pills.
I think maybe the mouthwash marked you up a little bit.
Might a little bit. Who knows what was in there? Apparently, there's a lot of alcohol in mouthwash. I'm just saying, don't do shots of alcohol. Don't swallow the mouthwash. I mean, some of them are alcohol-free now because kids were like doing shots of mouthwash because it was 40% alcohol.
Gross. Get some NyQuil.
Like a real adult. So this next one is going to do it for us, man. Thank you guys for spending some time with us. This is a Kitchen Killaz original. I hope you enjoyed. If you don't, that's okay. We still love you. This is called Sunkissed. Those harmonics, baby. There it is. Your ear picks up on it. It's lovely. I have wondered where this feeling's gone. Why's it been so long? I guess I had to wait for her to come along. So long. With that sun-kissed look upon her face. Gone without a trace. My whole world has seemed to stop in place, waiting for the day where my heart has skipped a beat, a feat no other has. Calls for me and my love, it runs above what feels like 1,003. And it's blinding here is how you run on the sun. To flame, straight to flame. I am captured by this morning song. Is I long? I wish you'd wake, pick up your phone and sing along with this song. With that morning light that breaks the crest of night, fight against what's right. Where her heart has skipped a beat, a feat no other has. Calls for her and her love, it runs above. It feels like 1,003 in this blinding heat, and she runs.
like a thousand three. In his blinding heat, his eye around all the sun. Just to stay close to you. And she runs on the sun.
Certainly appreciate it. My name is Billy Floyd, and that is...
I'm the Commodore!
That's true, baby. We're the Kitchen Killaz from Orlando, Florida. Crashing kitchens all around the country, and you let us know if there's a kitchen you would like crashed. We have 3 dates left.
Right.
I'm asking, and hopefully there's somebody in the feed that might know what those dates are. November 15th? December, I don't know it. No, no. November 29th.
November 15th, November 29th, and December 5th. 6th, yeah. December 6th.
December 6th. Two Novembers and one December?
Two Novembers and one
two
December.
Two Novembers, one December, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. So thank you guys for spending some time with us tonight. I just see my man Nick just dropped in from Dropkick Radio. What up, Nick?
What's
great
up,
to see
man?
You, bro. We just booked another show with them on July 18th, which I'm super stoked.
We're
going back for another brew
man,
battle, baby. That's what I'm
keeps
talking about.
Up.
Josh Bauer again says Deuce wants December. Well, I'm just saying, baby. Happy Hour wants the December date. You got it. In your face. Always taken care of, my man.
Ugly sweater party.
What is going on? An ugly sweater party. I love it, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Hold on a second. There's a bunch of stuff coming through. Elizabeth Ann says Pop-Tart. Kevin B. Blood says Pop-Tart.
Yeah.
What's going on? Allison B. says Pop-Tart. What
says
is
Pop-Tart?
Happening, baby? All the Pop-Tarts, man. I don't know what's going on. You guys want Pop-Tarts? What? Pop-Tarts now? We have this amazing edible arrangement behind us.
There's
and you want Pop-Tarts?
So much good food here.
I mean,
Pop-Tarts are awesome.
I'm going to leave it up.
So.
You guys got to talk to the Commodore. I'll be right back. I'm going to check out this edible arrangement.
Yeah, I'll be right back. I'm just kidding. Hey, if you'll just allow me, easy. Just
calm
give
down.
Me a moment.
Calm down, Josh Bauer.
My
I see you over there, sir. Yeah.
I see you over there, sir.
I see you here and there. I see
everywhere.
You. What up, Michelle? Great to see you.
Let me check.
Thank you guys for
any Pop-Tarts on my E string.
Oh, sounds like it. Girls Gone Naughty started following you. Wow. Naughty, K-N-O-T-T-Y. I just thought I'd share it with you because what a creative name. I wonder if they're talking about Shibari. It's after 9:30. Google Shibari, ladies and gentlemen. 18 and up only. Just throwing it out there. He knows. So thank you guys for joining us tonight. We definitely appreciate it. That's right, November 15th, November 29th, and December 6th. Looks like Deuce on the Loose has got December 6th, which leaves us with 2 dates left to book for the rest of the year. So please let us know if there's a kitchen and you would like us to crash, and we will make it happen, ladies and gentlemen. We did not write this one, but one day, Peter Griffin and Glenn Quagmire got into an argument. They were yelling at each other, screaming at each other, and they realized they harmonized with each other really, really well, which was super cool. So they decided to write some music and take it on the word, baby, which was freaking crazy. And they wrote about things that they loved, a combination of things they loved. One of the things Peter Griffin loved was a Pop-Tart. The other thing that Glenn Quagmire loved was butter. So they decided to write a song about Pop-Tarts and butter. What only the greatest combination this side of the Mississippi, baby. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you guys know how to sing it. There's a part during the song where I say, have you ever put butter on A? And then the entire crowd, including Jim Dunn, the man who wears the hat like none other, says Pop-Tart. I hope you guys enjoy this. Have you ever put butter on a Pop-Tart? It's so freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a Pop-Tart? If you haven't, then I think you should. I really do 100%, I swear. I was sitting in the kitchen one day and I was itching to fill up my belly with a pipe and nut jelly of the best damn treat in the world.
He's talking Pop-Tarts.
And I saw a stick of butter and it almost made me shudder and scream like a baby girl. I don't want a giant penis or a rocket ship to Venus. I don't want to win the lottery. I just want to squat and gulp, dizzy and a wobble and a butterfruit and dilly tart dream. So
I put butter on a Pop-Tart, it's so freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a Pop-Tart? If you haven't, then I think you should.
This is where everybody sings along. I'm really happy. This is my favorite part of the entire song. I hope you guys had a really great night. Thank you for hanging out with us. My name's Willie Floyd, and that is
I'm the Commodore.
We're the Kitchen Killaz from Orlando, Florida. Crushing kitchens all around the country. Recording Goose Doo, and we do it for free. So just let us know. We got 3 days left.
We're
just getting two
food.
Because Deuce got it, baby. Are you ready? Have you ever put
butter
on a
Pop-Tart?
It's so freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a
Pop-Tart?
If you haven't, then I think you should.
Pop-Tart.
With butter.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you guys for hanging out with us tonight. My name is Billy Quinn, and that is... That's right, baby. And here are all the amazing people that we have in the host and hall. Around 360 degrees. That's how we do it. So thank you guys for spending some time with us. A huge shout out to Lauren Edinger for allowing us to crash this kitchen and make it happen. She supplied us with amazing people, incredible food, and one hell of an experience. And by all means, don't forget to hit up my man Pepe. He's got a free cultural dance coming from you at pepedancesfordollars.com. We are really, really excited about it. We have one more thing left to do. This must happen. Ladies and gentlemen, this goes to the great Commodore. If you can tell exactly what this is, that's right, baby. This is a Kitchen Killaz magnet that you can only get one way. You need
I'm
more?
I'm just throwing things.
We're throwing things. I'm going to unplug you, and you guys are coming with me. Let's see if we can do it.
Let's see if we can do it!
Stuff, things, stuff. You're coming with me, battery backup.
So last time, I was holding it right side up, and I threw it, and it landed upside down. So I'm going to try it the other way around.
Oh, yeah.
It just makes sense. You know what I mean?
Is this a real magnet for refrigerator, or is this one of those fake magnets?
Nope, we're good. Did you guys know that some refrigerators are made and they're not magnetic on the front?
What the heck is that?
That is a thing. There are actually refrigerators out there that aren't magnetic on the front. Get it together, Kenmore. Frigidaire. What is this one? Whirlpool's got it right.
Whirlpool,
look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Whirlpool.
Bam.
Oh.
Got it right.
Oh, that was awesome.
Thank you guys for hanging out with us. We'll talk to you guys soon. Please keep in touch. We will see you Monday night for the wrap-up, baby. Check out IndieSceneRadio.com on Sunday. I'm going to give it to the Commodore for a Facebook poke, and we'll talk to you soon.
Bye.